Recommendation 2 of the What Works Clearinghouse Practice Guide, Assisting Students Struggling with Mathematics, Intervention in the Elementary Grades, is about the mathematical language we use during instruction. The focus is on teaching clear and concise mathematical language and supporting students' use of this language to help them effectively communicate their understanding of mathematical concepts. By helping students develop this academic language during intervention sessions, we help students access the language used in Tier 1 core instruction. Students in intervention settings will need multiple exposures to mathematical language to understand the terminology and begin to integrate it into classroom discussions. The What Works Clearinghouse and the expert panel assigned a strong level of evidence to this recommendation, meaning that there is consistent evidence that meets not only the What Works Clearinghouse standards, but it indicates that this practice improves outcomes for diverse student populations. When teachers use conversational or informal language instead of mathematical language, students can get confused. For example, some teachers may refer to the commutative property as the flip-flop property. Although this name may be viewed as a fun memory device, replacing accurate terms with informal language such as this can cause serious confusion for students later in their schooling. This can occur when other teachers do not know the flip-flop property, or when learners do not know the connection of the flip-flop property to the formal term of the commutative property. Using and practicing correct terminology from the start can eliminate later challenges. The first step to carry out this recommendation is to routinely use and teach with precise mathematical vocabulary during instruction. Embed it into activities when using concrete or semi-concrete examples. A graphic organizer with the term unit fraction at the center can include a student-friendly definition, examples such as number lines or sketches of fractions pieces, as well as non-examples for clarification. This way, students remember and discriminate among different characteristics of a unit fraction. In the same way, the reading of an equal sign in a problem or equation should be equals, not is or makes, as in this example. 2 + 2 = 4. No, 2 + 2 = 4. The second action step is to use clear, concise, and correct mathematical language throughout lessons to reinforce students' understanding of important mathematical vocabulary words. So, for example, rather than use terminology such as reducing fractions, the whole school should agree to using simplifying fractions, which gets away from an inaccurate image of a fraction getting reduced. It's not getting smaller. It's not going on a diet. The same for outdated language, such as borrowing or carrying, which should be replaced with regrouping or trading, depending on your state standards or the curriculum you're using. Of course, we should get rid of phrases such as getting rid of the decimal or plugging numbers into an equation. Avoid teaching vocabulary in isolation and instead build it in exactly where it is needed to enhance the concepts you're presenting. So, for example, as students are multiplying, remind them the two numbers we're multiplying are the factors by naming them as such. Then refer to the answer as the product. Our consistent emphasis on the correct mathematical language builds over time into meaningful usage by the students. The third action step is to support students in using mathematically precise language during their verbal and written explanations of their problem solving. As we have students explain their work, we provide opportunities for students to communicate their understanding through new vocabulary while integrating and practicing language from their prior learning. By offering students prompts or sentence starters, we can provide the structure to focus students' ideas in ways others can agree with or question for clarity. Creating a math word wall with important terms partnered with their definition or representation can be a perfect resource for refreshing students' ideas and refreshing their language recently learned.